Welcome to Whole Apron. Let's make creamy spinach ravioli. This is one package of frozen chopped spinach that has completely thawed. We need to get all the excess moisture out of it. So we are going to take our hand and squeeze it for about 2 to 3 minutes, or until there is no more liquid coming out. Next, we will need to chop our basil. First, let's take a few fresh basil leaves and roll them into a tight ball, just like this. Hold it together so that it remains tight, and with your knife, slice it very thinly. Then turn your knife 90 degrees and chop in that direction. Continue to chop, alternating your knife in these two directions, and occasionally moving it to the center. Just keep repeating until it looks like this. Now we can put the filling together. In a mixing bowl, let's take one package of cream cheese and add our spinach that we squeezed the moisture out of, along with 1 teaspoon of garlic powder and our 4 teaspoons of fresh chopped basil. Now this is one of those things that quite literally needs to be mixed by hand, because the heat of your hand helps to soften the cream cheese. Notice that I'm clenching my hand and squeezing the mixture through my fingers. We will keep doing this until it's completely mixed. We're going to need a little egg wash. Let's go ahead and get that ready. Simply add 1 tablespoon of water to 1 egg and whisk it well. We now have everything ready to assemble the ravioli. Here I'm coating my surface with a little plain cornmeal. This is done to keep the ravioli from sticking to the surface. We're going to make our ravioli with wonton wrappers. They are a nice, delicate pasta and make excellent ravioli. We will start by lining them up in even rows. This recipe makes about 20 ravioli, so lay out 4 rows of 5, and then place about 1 teaspoon of the filling we made in the center of each one. After we've done that, we will go back and tidy them up, because we will need our edges clear so that the pasta will seal better together. Now it's time for the egg wash that we made. We will brush all 4 sides with a nice even coat, and then we will use another wonton wrapper for the top. After placing the tops on, we will pick each one up and squeeze the edges together. At this point, they are finished and it will be perfectly fine to cook them. But if you would rather have round ravioli, just take a 3-inch or about 7.62 centimeter pastry cutter and trim the edges. Now at this point, we can line them up on a baking sheet with parchment paper, cover them tightly with plastic wrap and foil, and they will freeze very nicely. But we're going to go ahead and cook these. So let's take 3 quarts, or about 3 liters of water, and add 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 tablespoon of olive oil, and bring it to a rapid boil, to which we will gently place in our ravioli. At this point, they're still pretty delicate, so just nudge them a little bit instead of stirring them to make sure you don't have any sticking together, and let them boil for about 5 minutes. At this point, they will have reached a rapid boil again and look like this. Then simply drain them and serve them with your favorite pasta sauce. They go equally well with tomato-based or cream-based sauces. But note, if you don't sauce them right away, you will need to toss them with a little bit of vegetable oil or olive oil to keep them from sticking together. Now that they're cooked, let's take a little closer look at them. The pasta is a great consistency, without being too thick and doughy. On the inside, the spinach is still a nice bright green, and there is just enough cream cheese to make it smooth and creamy. And the fresh basil with a touch of garlic complements it all very well. I have served them here with my red bell pepper cream sauce. If you are interested in making this sauce, the video is on my blog at wholeapron.com. I always have ingredient and measurement lists there as well. Thanks for watching, and remember, if I made this, so can you.